Today I was asked a question by a viewer in the comment section of one of my videos on how I would deal with the 74 school shootings that have occurred since Sandy Hook. Well, the first thing I would do is research that number and come to the conclusion that repeating it makes me kind of sound like an idiot, because if you look at the scientific method that they used to collect that data and the data that they actually did come up with, it's what we like to call in the scientific community bullshit. Now, this statistic that Every Town for Gun Safety came up with includes some pretty weird things as school shootings, and let's take a look at what a few of those things are. Out of those 74 school shootings, one of them was an armed robbery that occurred on a street that runs through a college campus. Another was a guy that committed suicide in his car after a domestic disturbance while parked outside of a school after hours. Another was a guy that committed suicide in his car in the parking lot of a college, once again, after hours. Another was a guy that had a negligent discharge while moving his firearm to the trunk of his car while on school property. In fact, out of those 74 school shootings, 65 of them didn't involve faculty, staff, students, etc., didn't occur during school hours, had absolutely nothing to do with the school really other than proximity. But the real numbers don't do their job of stirring up that image, that emotional reaction to the idea of children huddled in a corner while an active shooter roams the halls of their school. And that's what these people wanted to do with these numbers. That's what they want to invoke. They want us to be emotional. They don't want us to think. So they have no other choice than to expand the parameters of what would be considered a school shooting to ridiculous extremes to try to prove their agenda. I mean, really, when you go to the point of including a gang shooting that occurred on school grounds after hours, or a domestic disturbance where someone fired a gun and then fled across school property, when you include those in your numbers for school shootings, you're really being disingenuous. I mean, your dishonesty is really apparent if you read the small print of your study. Now, if you remove all these shootings that have absolutely nothing to do with schools or teachers or students, etc., you're only left with a few shootings. And then when you have to look at those numbers, you have to realize these people counted mostly things that happened on college campuses and in dormitories, not in grade schools or junior highs or high schools. So these weren't involving little kids like they want us to think they were. They were adults. And of the few that occurred in grade schools, junior highs, high schools, some of those weren't successful. Some of those were targets of a specific student wanting to go after a specific teacher. They weren't the mass shootings that they want you to think they were. So these numbers really don't hold as much weight as they would like you to think they hold. In fact, these numbers are just lies. They're just lies trying to elicit an emotional response. When they know they don't have an argument they can win with, they have to create a false argument. That's all these numbers are trying to do, create a false argument. But now, if you did ask me, how do I deal with those few school shootings that actually occurred in a school involving kids since Sandy Hook, I'd say, well, in almost every one of those cases, the problem could have been taken care of with restricted access, metal detectors, and maybe armed security. That would have solved all those problems. Those are actually real solutions to the problem. Those aren't emotional reactions. Those are real solutions. But if you insist on asking the question as, what am I going to do about the 74 school shootings since Sandy Hook, I'm not going to be able to do anything about that. I can't provide solutions for your fantasies or your fallacies. All I can do is what anyone that actually cares about the problem can do. I'm going to deal with real-world things, things that actually happen, and I'm going to try to provide solutions for those things that actually did happen. I'm not going to go around trying to foster hysteria and further my agenda through misinformation and lies.